Hey everyone, for today's video, we'll be taking a look at the Gigabyte B660M DS3H AX DDR4 motherboard. This board is an entry-level offering by Gigabyte, sporting the mid-range Intel B660 chipset, which offers an inroad to the latest Intel 12th generation Alder Lake processors. Now, as the model name implies, this board offers DDR4 support on the Alder Lake platform, not DDR5, which as a result should help to lower the overall cost of building a PC with this board. Before we begin, big thanks to CDL Trading, the authorized distributor for Gigabyte in Singapore, for loaning me this board for this video. Let's get started. As always, let's talk about the packaging first. The B660M DS3H AX DDR4 belongs to the budget-oriented ultra-durable series of motherboards by Gigabyte, placing beneath the mid-tier Gigabyte Gaming series and the top-of-the-line Aorus series of motherboards. The B660M, therefore, comes in the usual black and bronze colorway that has come to be associated with the ultra-durable series of boards. Now, moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual overview of specs for this board, nothing particularly fancy to call out here. We'll cover the board specs in depth in the next few minutes of this video. With that, let's get on with unboxing the board. Setting aside the board for the moment, we see that the B660M DS3H AX DDR4 comes with minimal accessories. First up, we get the Wi-Fi antenna, which is unsurprising really, seeing as this board comes with built-in Wi-Fi. Apart from that, we get two SATA cables. And this is accompanied by two M2 drive screws. On top of these, we get an I.O. shield, seeing as this board does not come with an integrated I.O. shield design, and this is rounded off by a condensed version of the motherboard manual. Interestingly, Gigabyte's chosen to do away with a DVD driver disc, which I suppose won't be missed, seeing as modern PCs don't come with optical drives anymore anyway. With that, onto the board itself. And here we have it, the B660M DS3H AX DDR4. Gigabyte has gone with a light grey on black colour scheme with these angled motifs in the lower half of the board, which do lend some visual appeal to it. Do note that the board does not come with an integrated I.O. shield design as mentioned earlier, nor does it come with built-in RGB LEDs of any sort, though of course there are onboard RGB headers, which I'll speak about later on. The board only comes with a single VRM heatsink, which as you can see, is not exactly sizable. And the same can be said of the passive heatsink that is included for the B660 chipset. That being said, it's great to note that Gigabyte has included a M2 drive heatsink, which is a welcome addition for sure. For memory support, the B660M DS3H AX DDR4 comes with 4 DDR4 slots, not DDR5, with support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR4 5333 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a dual tab design. Right next to the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header. While still on the topic of USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers. It's great to note that Gigabyte's included a QFlash Plus button right here that allows users to update the BIOS without a CPU, RAM, and graphics card installed via a USB thumb drive with the BIOS ROM loaded on it. To the right of the QFlash Plus button is a reset switch that allows you to reset your PC in an open case environment, which could come in handy for sure. In terms of expansion slots, this entry-level board comes with a single PCIe 4.0 X16 slot and two PCIe 3.0 X1 slots, with all three slots made of plastic. In the storage department, Gigabyte has included four SATA 3 ports, with two in a right-angled configuration and two in a straight-angled configuration. For M2 slots, it comes equipped with dual PCIe 4.0 X4 M2 slots, of which, as mentioned earlier, one of them comes equipped with a heatsink. For audio, Gigabyte has included a Realtek ALC897 audio codec, which is a pretty standard audio codec that can be found in most lower-end motherboards. Internet connectivity, on the other hand, is courtesy of Realtek's RTL8125BG chip, which provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. Now this is definitely a welcome feature to have, especially for an entry-level motherboard. For wireless internet connectivity, do note that the wireless chipset that comes included with the B660M DS3H AXDDR4 varies according to the board revision number. This can be checked by simply looking at the sticker that is stuck to the side of the box or checking what's printed on the board itself. Now for this particular board that I have here, revision 1.0, it comes with Intel's AX201 Wi-Fi 6 part with Bluetooth 5.2. Revision 1.1 of the board, on the other hand, comes with Intel's AX200, which is also a Wi-Fi 6 part with Bluetooth 5.2. Now, the latest revision of the B660M DS3H AXDDR4, that is, revision 1.2, comes with the Intel AX211 chip, which supports the more superior Wi-Fi 6E standard and also has Bluetooth 5.2 support. With this in mind, I'd highly recommend checking the board revision number if possible before making a purchase, especially since the latest board revision would grant you access to the latest Wi-Fi 6E standard. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 4 fan headers which are located in these regions of the board. Also included is a single addressable RGB header, as well as a 12-volt standard RGB header located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the B660M DS3H AXDDR4 goes for a traditional I/O layout with an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with 2 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, with the top port here supporting the QFlash Plus feature should you wish to update your BIOS without a CPU, RAM or graphics card installed. We also do get a PS2 connector for a mouse or keyboard, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, a HDMI 2.0 port, dual DisplayPort 1.2 connectors, 3 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, as well as your standard audio jack connectors. To sum up, Gigabyte's B660M DS3H AXDDR4 is a solid offering of an entry-level B660 board for Intel's 12th generation Alder Lake processors. For its price, it sure packs a good mix of legacy features such as DDR4 support while granting access to newer features such as PCIe 4.0, 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, and if you're able to score for yourself the latest revision of this motherboard, Wi-Fi 6E as well. As of May 2022, the B660M DS3H AXDDR4 can be had for a price of around 240-ish Singapore dollars through retailers at places such as Sim Lim Square, or for you international folks out there, approximately 140 US dollars on e-commerce platforms such as Amazon or Newegg. With that, thanks so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.